गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ रेस्पिरेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड विच काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स यूजली फॉर्म आफ्टर द रेस्पिरेशन। वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस दैट हाउ मैनी टाइप्स ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन मैकेनिज्म्स टेक्स प्लेस लाइक एरोबिक एंड एनारोबिक एंड विच टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म and body parts mainly shows this type of reproduction, respiration mode. In our next class today, we are going to discuss how respiration takes place in human being. Earlier we have discussed the common mode of respiration in all organism, but today we are going to read only human respiratory system, because you know very well that human is a very most we can say developed organism, modified organism among all. So earlier we have discussed that how the breakdown of food takes place inside our cells in the absence or presence of oxygen. In the both case we have discussed, but today we are going to start only human respiratory system. You know that we are having a well developed system, respiratory system, in which lungs is the main respiratory organ. After that there are so many accessory organs like bronchi, bronchioles, trachea, nasal path, diaphragm. These all are the supporting organ which helps in the respiration. So trachea, which is normally known as windpipe, behind that food pipe is present. I am indicating this with the help of marker, that is esophagus. We have right over there esophagus which is present behind the trachea or behind the windpipe, that is dark red structure showing that the presence of trachea. This is the trachea in which cartilaginous rings are present which prevent this trachea in the absence of oxygen from the collapsing. You know that our respiratory path is started from nostrils, and these nostrils are present as a two pore at our ventral surface of face, and they opens into a chamber like structure that is called nasal cavity. This nasal cavity directly leads to the pharynx, and pharynx leads to the larynx. Larynx is normally known as voice box. It also helps in the speaking in human being because it can produce various type of sounds and vowels. Now the larynx opens into the trachea, generally known as windpipe, which has cartilaginous rings. Actually these are C-shaped cartilage rings which prevent this trachea or windpipe from collapsing in the absence of oxygen. Now this trachea going to divide into two separate bronchi. Each bronchi opens into the separate lung, right lung and left lung. You know very well that the right lung is little bit larger than the left lung in human being, and between both the lungs heart is situated, that is cardiac notch is to be present at there in which heart is located. Below the both of lungs, one of the muscular sheath is present, that is called diaphragm. By this black indication I am showing diaphragm is located below the lungs. Okay, now so this is the common respiratory system of human being, and you know that alveoli is the basic structural and functional unit of our lungs, because lungs are made by these alveoli. How this alveoli look like? यू कैन सी लाइक अ बबल इन इन आर लंग्स विच इज सराउंडेड बाय द ब्लड कैपिलरीज. इन बोथ डायग्राम इट इज शोन दैट कि हाउ ब्लड कैपिलरीज कवर द एल्वियोलाई. दीज एल्वियोलाई कंप्लीटली फिल्ड विद एयर एंड द एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज और द डिफ्यूजन ऑफ गैसेज टेक्स प्लेस बिटवीन दीज ब्लड कैपिलरीज एंड एल्वियोलाई. वॉट एवर वी इनहेल थ्रू आर नेजल कैविटी इन आर लंग्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एयर दैट इज कम्प्लीटली गोज इन टू आर एल्वियोलाई एंड आफ्टर दैट वॉट एवर द कैपिलरीज सराउंड्स दीज एल्वियोलाई एब्जॉर्ब दिस गैसेज और एयर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन आर एल्वियोलाई. First of all, we are going to read this. Air enters through the nostril. Actually, we are discussing the path. The hairs and mucus trap the dust particles. It then passes through the pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi and enters the lungs. It is a completely, we are indicating the path of respiratory system. Okay, how gases move towards one by one. The trachea has rings of cartilage which prevent it from collapsing when there is no air in the trachea. I have said this thing also earlier. The bronchi divides into smaller tube called bronchioles which ends in tiny air sac called alveoli. The alveoli is supplied with blood vessels through which exchange of gases takes place. The alveoli helps to increase the surface area for the exchange of gases. You know that whatever the amount of airs are present in our alveoli and these are usually surrounded by blood capillaries, that is exchange of gases takes place between both of them. Actually, they permit the exchange of gases with each other because blood absorbs the oxygen and alveoli is filled with CO2 during the exhalation process. In case of inhalation or intake of oxygen absorbed by this blood and CO2 is released out in the alveoli. So one by one we are going to read these all diagrams. First of all, that is the human lungs. Then how nose leads to the mouth, epiglottis, pharynx, larynx, trachea and how it is look like. Actually, it is a 3D diagram with 3D color diagram which showing that how lungs are present and how they are surrounded by our rib cage that is present or the present in the protected form in our rib cage. And diaphragm is also present at there is as a muscular sheet. So this is the overall diagram of our respiratory system. Now one by one we are going to discuss. First of all, that is the alveoli sac which are present in our lungs and these are surrounded by the blood capillaries and that is similar diagram. So there is not a big difference between both. One of them you can make any one diagram. So for today class that is enough. Today we have discussed the respiratory system of human and how respiration takes place in human being, which kind of special organs are present for the respiration in human. In our next class where we discuss how breathing mechanism takes place or mechanism of respiration takes place in human. Till today, have a nice day. Goodbye, all my dear students.